Long Range Strike Bomber Program, or the LRS-B for short, is a development and acquisition program to develop a long-range strategic bomber for the United States Air Force. This heavy payload stealth aircraft would be capable of delivering thermonuclear weapons across the globe. The conception of this program started in mid-2009, when Air Force Chief of Staff General Norton Schwartz said that the Air Force's focus in 2010 was to be on the development of a long-range strike aircraft instead of a next-generation bomber. At first, the concept was met with a great deal of scrutiny. It didn't have anything to do with the idea itself, though. The worry was that it would be a financial disaster. When addressing it, Secretary of Defense Gates said, "What we must not do is repeat what happened with our last manned bomber. By the time the research, development, and requirements processes ran their course, the aircraft, despite its great capability, turned out to be so expensive, $2 billion each in the case of the B-2 Spirit, that less than one-sixth of the planned fleet of 132 was ever built." As an answer to this problem, the Department of Defense determined that the Air Force would need to handle reconnaissance as well as strike missions, displaying a new level of versatility. With the plan in place, funding was secured. In 2011, the Air Force decided to purchase 80 to 100 aircraft. Air Force Global Strike Command indicated that one requirement for the bomber would be to carry a weapon of similar effect to the massive ordnance penetrator. In addition to the strategic bombing, tactical bombing, and prompt global strike roles it would serve. Then, President Obama and his administration went further to include additional stipulations, saying the aircraft should be nuclear capable, but shall not be certified as such until older bombers were set to retire. After a few other requirements were added over the next couple of years, plans were finally put in place. Production proposals and contracts were put in place. Originally, Boeing and Lockheed Martin were to team up on the LRS-B project, as they have always been the frontrunners in the vast majority of military contracts for the United States. Something different happened this time. In October of 2015, it was announced that the contract for the program was awarded to Northrop Grumman. Lockheed and Boeing were furious at the decision and protested. However, the government did not budge, citing cost issues. Although Lockheed Martin and Boeing had made plans to bring a lawsuit against the government, the plans were eventually dropped, giving America the go-ahead to continue work with Northrop Grumman. Everything was clear from Northrop Grumman to start its work. At the 2016 Air Warfare Symposium, the LRS-B aircraft was formally designated the B-21. The head of the U.S. Air Force Global Strike Command expects that there will be a minimum order of 100 B-21 bombers, yet thinks that the order could one day climb to as high as 200. Later on in 2016, the B-21 was formally named Raider, in honor of the Doolittle Raiders, which were the pilots who flew the first air raid over Honshu, Japan in 1942. The remaining survivor of the Doolittle Raiders, retired Lieutenant Colonel Richard E. Cole, was present at the naming ceremony at the Air Force Association Conference. So, now that we know the history of the project, let's get into the actual aircraft. What will it look like? What purpose will it serve? What can we expect as far as performance? The Northrop Grumman B-21 Raider is an American heavy bomber that is currently under development for the United States Air Force by the global aerospace and defense technology company, Northrop Grumman. As part of the Long Range Strike Bomber program, it is to be an advanced, very long range, large, heavy payload stealth intercontinental strategic bomber, with capabilities of delivering conventional and thermonuclear weapons. It is to complement the existing fleet of LRS-Bs, the Rockwell B-1 Lancer, Northrop Grumman's B-2 Spirit, and the Boeing B-52 Stratofortress. Eventually, though, the B-21 would replace them all. At this point in the development, very little has been made public about its actual cost or capabilities. It has been argued that releasing the costs and the capabilities would reveal too much information about the classified project to potential adversaries. For those that don't remember, the development of the atomic was leaked to the Soviet Union by carefully placed spies here in the United States. Because of this, the Soviets were able to develop their own atomic bombs, putting much of the world at threat and eventually causing the Cold War. So what's the big deal then? Yeah, it sounds like a novel idea that could lead to some serious advantages for the United States in wars to come. But what is there to know about this thing? Why should we even care? Well, here's the thing. There's more to this whole thing than just the development of a new warplane. The LRS-B is an event that will have rippling effects throughout our culture and economy in the years to come. But even before the first prototype has been put into the air, a slew of things are already happening. New standards are being set for military aviation. New concepts are being explored in terms of the nuclear arsenal of other countries. Espionage efforts are probably going into high gear. All of these things, even in the early stages of this program, highlight the great importance that this will play in the near future. Another great thing that can be highlighted by the LRS-B program is just how much of a powerhouse it will be. In the history of the United States Air Force, thousands of planes have entered service and exited all the same. New military jets come and go. However, the bombers are in an entirely different league. Much like when the aircraft carriers were rolled out for the first time, they symbolize the United States' ability to go anywhere in the world and exert its influence. In short, when the B-21 is rolled out, there will be no place on the planet that this bomber will not be able to reach. So, it has influence, but what about its arsenal and firepower? To answer these questions, people have had to employ the work of analysts as well as to rely on already public information from senior military officials. Senior Air Force officials have reported that the bomber will be rated to carry nuclear weapons, acknowledging the enduring existential threat posed by Russia, China, and North Korea. Another source for information was aerospace analyst Richard Abulafia. In a magazine interview, Abulafia said, "A platform with terrific penetrating capability and wonderful avionics, from a cyber warfare standpoint, is a fantastic asset." What this basically translates to is that the bomber would have to accommodate various types of exotic weaponry, such as direct energy beams, advanced decoys, and computer viruses. With information like this, we can see how this new bomber will be the most advanced piece of aerospace technology ever used in war. With this amount of technology, along with the fact that the United States Air Force has purchased 100 B-21 bombers, with more on the way, we can see how the Northrop Grumman will not only be the new standard in the future of bombers, it will most likely not be beaten for a number of years. It is typical for some aircraft programs to die before their real potential is realized. Many survive, but end up seeing production totals and numbers way less than what was expected. Will the Northrop Grumman be the next thing that fades quickly? At this point, it's still anyone's guess, as its release is still far into the future. Let's just hope that after all of the back and forth and secrecy, there will be a sturdy product put out. So, what do you think? Tell us what your hopes are for the B-21 bomber in the comments below. We want you to know how much we appreciate you being here. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give us a thumbs up. While you're here, check out some of our previous videos. We have enough aviation content to keep you busy and learning for hours. Thank you so much for watching.